Hello everyone, welcome to the Binding of Isaac Not Daily Runs. We're going to do hard mode. We do only need to find items, so we could do normal mode. But I'm not going to. I'm going to keep hitting random until we find these last two items. What do we need? Crown of Light. Keeper. Interesting. Crown of Light. And Immaculate Conception. So we're playing as the Keeper. This is basically the lost. Expect deaths. Expect me not to do well. There's a good start. Let's flip this here so we get a coin. We did. Don't really want that, but we'll blow it up. Yeah, we'll take the virus. If we're going to hit things, we might as well sort of get some retribution for them. Before doing so, I suppose, from them. This would have been a much better room to use a bomb on, but there we are. Keeper, not an easy character. It's the new challenge character, but we're here for playing the game rather than any particular brownie points for beating Keeper. We don't need to beat anything now. I've done everything. I'm perfectly happy. We'll flip the coin every time it is available on the way into a room. There's our bomb. We should definitely brave this room and try and go back and see what we get. It's Tinted Rock. Now, Tinted Rocks are only valuable as a Keeper until you get Small Rock out of it, and then you are free to leave and go about your life. Or do we open this? This could be a lot more valuable to us and could give us a secret room, which it did. Secret room contains a red fire, a couple more bombs. So now we can get the Tinted Rock as well, and possibly even that key, which honestly might even be more useful to us than the contents of the Tinted Rock. But we're not going to get the key from this bomb. More bombs. Then we'll definitely get the key. Thank you. Tempted to use a key, use a bomb to avoid this room, but maybe a little bit trigger happy on the bomb usage there. So every time this is available, we are going to flip a coin when we walk into a room. If we get a coin, we have a little bit of peace of mind that we can survive without dying on that exact room. Good. It's probably a super secret room, actually. Let's have a look. We'll start for 10. Bang. Not very well. Shoot all the fires. All the coins that you can leave on the ground are valuable. You just have to not get hit twice on one room, which is slightly easier than not getting hit at all as the lost. But of course, if you are lost incorrectly, you will have eventually unlocked Holy Mantle. Don't pick up the coin yet. Shoot the poops. Oh, hello. Thanks for playing. Please shoot faster. Keeper starting with triple shot is... I mean, I like triple shot, but I like the option of not taking it if our rate of fire is already shit. Still no small rock there. If you're wondering where the flies are coming from, because the Keeper doesn't use traditional HP, any and all forms of HP are becoming flies when they appear, when they spawn. All spirit hearts, all red hearts, all half red hearts. Oh, you fucking dick. Hate that. This guy's got so many fucking attacks that can just do you in. Homing shots, homed so aggressively. Please. No more fucking spiders, yo. No! Stop doing that, it's bullshit. Man, I hate the fucking... I hate Ragman. Were we even allowed to say that? Jesus shitting Christ. Next. It's hard, okay? Nothing in here. At least this is basement. Burning basement can go suck a dick. Let's flip that. Nickel. Now, the nice thing about this is if you get hit once, you've still got 4 cents from the nickel. We just got, like, 11 cents. Well, 10. Just got 10 cents from one room. I'm down with that. That could actually really fund an amazing upgrade for us at some point in the future, provided we can get the keys to get into the shop. I mean, we didn't get much of an upgrade on the previous floor. On the start of the previous run. And as the Keeper, much like as the Lost, you're going to get a huge benefit from very early excellent items, basically. Anything that can increase your rate of fire or at least your damage to the extent where your triple shot can one-shot most things is going to help. And if you're going to get mediocre shit like you normally do on this fucking game, you're going to have a bad time. That's what I'm saying. Please. Thank you. Health down. Bad trip. basically the same thing. Let's go and find the item room. We don't want to fight the boss yet because I'm salty about these bosses. Ah, as the keeper, of course, we can go into any shop for free anyway, so we should do so. In all situations, we can explode. We can get 2 cents out. I will come back with 2 cents. I expect we can get 2 cents from the coin flips. And if we can't, we can explode the donation machine. Oh, hello. I'll put this here. Kind of hoping to get the, I'm hoping to get, why did I walk into that enemy? The secret room, I was hoping to find the secret room there, or a super secret room, especially. Nope. But it didn't work out that way. I'm not playing very well today, this is the second run I've done. I've just fucked up a daily, so, very nice. Speed and shot speed is pretty decent. I'm going to treat this hermit card as a get out of something card rather than a get into something card because we don't need to worry about getting into the shop. I'll pick up more options at the end of the floor. Honestly, I don't think like not having more options on this floor is that bad because we did well out of it anyway, out of the item room. But I would like to have more options on future item rooms for sure. A speed upgrade at this stage has actually turned out to be quite useful for us because avoiding Steven is so much easier when you can run away just that little bit faster. I wouldn't have minded something slightly better than speed and shot speed, e.g. I wouldn't have minded some damage, but you know, you can't win them all. Excuse me. How much damage are you taking right now? It's kind of like having Eve's mascara. Because unless you can hit with all three shots, which is super rare without getting stupidly close to an enemy, that is like dangerously close to an enemy, you're basically only hitting with the middle shot and then as a bonus the other two shots. So early on, triple shot is actually a massive disadvantage. We still haven't got any money here, so we'll go and explode the donation machine with our only bomb. This is a much more guaranteed way of producing coinage than it would be to... Wow, it still only gave us two. That could have actually given us one coin, which would have been shit, but never mind. We have no consumables left, but that's okay. We've given ourselves a great advantage by means of more options, which means any item room which has a shit item in it, we could be doing really well out of because that could have been the item that was already going to be there. And then there will be an alternative item to choose from. Yes, very good. Not that. Hello? Our speed is great right now, and it is actually slightly confusing me because I've forgotten how to not be sluggish as all hell. Steven, deal with it. Dude, what do I carry you for? We're going to keep the shop key. I think the shop key is very useful as the keeper. It's very useful in any situation, to be fair. Wouldn't mind a bomb out of this room, though. You see your way clear? To providing me with a bomb. At the end of this room, then we can get some great advantages out of it. By placing it strategically amongst the rocks over here. Bomb. Could have got that joker to be near the things we want to explode, but that was going to be a very difficult thing to achieve. We have got a coin, so we can get hit, but please don't. That gave us flies because that champion gives us flies, which is super nice. This champion explodes into an array of tears. A starburst of tears, avoid that. And that one died to a fly, which gave us a key, which gets us into here, which gives us another triple shot. Now, I have taken this before, and I'm going to take it again. But I can't get in there just now. It is extremely slow to fire, but it's extremely good fun. So I'm going to take it, although I know it's terrible. Hematemesis actually just gave us flies in exchange for our HP, which is bullshit. I don't want that. I suppose that's what you'd expect, you know, it puts you down at 1 HP, always has done. Yeah, there's a bomb for sale, but we can't really... I should be flipping this coin. Why am I not? Have to take that. No, here's what we do. We push this out of the way. Then we shoot it. I really do want to get... Hello? Thank you. I really do want to get triple shot, triple shot. It sounds terrible, and it is. But I would very much like a bomb in order to prove it. Fail this run. Stop recording at 20 minutes, 30 minutes anyway, and completely fail to get any of the items that we're here to get, which are, I believe, Godhead, And Crown of Light, we did actually pick up Immaculate Conception in a recent run. There's our bomb. I would like that card as well, but, you know, first things first. The triple shot has first dibs. And I'm going to show how outrageously foolish it is to pick up triple shot. And then you will all go, lololol. What a fool. Why did he pick up triple shot? So now we have 6 shots every... This is the fastest we can fire. But we are fanning out all our damage in front of us like a fucking sprinkler. Garden sprinkler. In the midst of a Florida summer. I don't know. Where would you normally use a garden sprinkler in this configuration? My parents used to have one when I was a kid. In the house they're still in now, which just shows how old my parents are. How old I am, Jesus. We used to have a sprinkler, but I could not tell you what my parents would sprinkle, apart from just the garden. Right? I mean, unless it was just always hot back then. Then any summer where it doesn't rain enough, but you need your sprinkler. This is interesting. Oh, you dick. We can't take either of these because we are going to die. But both of those are great. Whatever. We've got all stats upgraded. It doesn't count for HP. But it counts for everything else, including rate of fire and damage. And range. And speed. I mean, I could say including and then just list every stat if that would help. But I don't have a sprinkler now. I don't really use my hosepipe. That's probably because it's been pissing it down for the past several weeks. But I mean, if it hadn't been pissing it down, would I even be allowed to use my sprinkler? We have a hosepipe ban in this country every time it's too hot. Like, every time there's not enough water, every time there's basically a drought, which is basically when it's too hot. I'm kind of conflating heat with, you know, levels of moisture in the air. But you know what I'm saying, when it's a particularly sunny, dry summer, that's when you'd use your sprinkler, but of course that's when there's not enough water to put on the ground in the first place. Meanwhile, who gives a crap about the garden if it's constantly pissing it down in these tropical fucking thunderstorms we've been having? In, what is it, June? Yeah, we'll do this. We might as well hermit out. Unless we just want to fight it. Maybe one of these is telepills. We've got a relax pill, which means they're not showing up there. Rain's down. Kind of doesn't help, but okay. We could just fight it. Send me the... I'm leaving. It's terrible. I hate that room. Right. I've got 5 cents, but there's nothing in there that I've really cared to buy. I mean, 5 cents for a 50% chance of getting 1 cent. I have to be honest, if you think that's a good trade, maybe you should just leave it to the professionals at this stage. Can you, can I even fire fast enough? Luckily, I have Steven firing for me, so if my actual rate of fire is not enough to get something done, like to kill a goo on the ground, we've got Steven there helping out, which is also cool. Now, we have to navigate this a little bit better than I did in the daily. This particular room didn't show up in the daily, but these bastards did. Being able to navigate these rooms does at least give you some appreciation. Well, attempting to navigate these rooms gives you some appreciation of how valuable it is to be able to predict when you're about to shoot. This is normally all the time, right? You normally just have a stream of shots. I'll tell you what, playing the keeper is a great way of getting Godhead, because Godhead tends to show up in angel rooms. Right? And as the keeper, you can so rarely justify taking a deal with the devil. You're very likely to end up with an angel run. You have to qualify for it, which it puts a bit of a damper on the situation, because it's very hard to get through an entire keeper floor without taking any hits at all. Speaking of which, we should probably put this particular penny. But you can still qualify for deals with the devil even though you took damage. Which then translates as deal with the angel, which then translates to Godhead, and everyone rejoices. So, please. What else is on this? What is going on here? Why are you making such a mess? Leave my domicile immediately. John Spartan. Let's get rid of these things before they produce more freaking spiders. Good grief. Look at our rate of fire. This is why we don't take the combination of things that I took. And nevertheless, I took it. And we're still doing okay. Prayer card doesn't really nothing for us. I guess we take Spider Babby, but again, it doesn't do anything for us. It's just... Everything's shit. Kind of want to see if there's a secret room here. Yeah, there is. Good on you. Good on you, Dave. Thanks, Steve. Fudge. Oh, I hate this room. It's gonna be, we're gonna be here forever. Just deal with it. We didn't get a coin, so we can't get hit. I mean, it's kind of a case of everything shows up, you fire once, everything disappears. Rinse, repeat, grow old, regret, right? Thank you for the whatever hit that. Because it wasn't me, it was probably Steven. Jesus Christ, at least to give the game some credit, our own homing tiers home at least as aggressively as the bullshit mongers, the ragman ones do. I think the secret room may be here. It is not. Bob's Rotten Head, you have let me down for the last time. Pestilence! Shit. I hate this. All these bombs everywhere and creep. Help. Barely fire. I can't hit it. I can't hit it with a significant proportion of my actual shots, right? Which is gonna cause a problem. You know, ideally, when you've got a triple shot, you go in, you know, try and hit it with all three shots. How the hell am I supposed to hit it with all six shots? Especially when half the shots are being absorbed by his ads. Get around there. Good. Excellent. Now he's doing different enemies. We can at least get rid of these jokers on the ground. The ground jokers, as they are called. Yeah, it's flies now. Still pretty shitty because he's still going to keep doing those bombs. But Steven, help. Any tiers upgrade, please. Even if it's a pill. Unless the pill is amongst the set. Oh, you walked on the creep, dildo. Unless the... Unless it comes with... Of course we're going to get this. I knew that. Well, no deal with the devil. We didn't deserve one. How are we going to get through this? I'm actually doing better than I did on the previous run, even though I have absolutely, you know, buggered myself over with this triple shot nonsense. But hey, it's fun. Right. Fellows. You're dead. That's good. We could start using Cupid Meat to deal a lot of damage to many things that get too close to us, which is not a terrible option, especially on these things where you can predict where the fallout of doing so will be, i.e. you know that they're going to shoot in a cross shape and none of the bullets will hit you. Get in there and melee them, which is why I'm obviously doing exactly that right now. It's very scary to do that, which is why I'm not doing it. Because as the keeper, you don't really get that much room for mistakes. Mistakes will be made, but not by me. Please. And of course, when you can't actually reach them, that also makes things a bit difficult. Let's go in here. Blow it up. Didn't mean to do that. We did get a key, and probably a lot of red hearts out of the blood bank, so that gave us a lot of... flies, and we've got even more flies from what was presumably a bunch of hearts. Otherwise unreachable. But having turned into flies, they are now actually very valuable to us. It does seem very arbitrary that hearts should turn into flies, but at the same time, we've got to do something with them. This would be a great time to get Ipecac. It would be a great time to get a steam sale. Let's see if we can get enough money out of this. Gave me 2 cents, which is quite nice. I appreciate that. One more explosion here might do it. Not, yeah, it did. So we'll do that. We'll buy the Steam sale at full price. And then hopefully we can come back and get Spider Mod, because I do like Spider Mod. Just for itself. The knowledge of what's about to... Oh, well, there we go. It's almost the entirety of Spider Mod paper already. Just the ability to know what's going on. Is quite valuable indeed. I don't want to get in there because it's going to be scary. Help. Trying to do it sort of in tandem with the rotation of my orbital, but at the same time, kind of having trouble doing that. There's enough money already to get spider mod, so we will go and do that. Spider mod tells you how much damage enemies have, and honestly, it's actually a very valuable thing to know. And the reason I find it very valuable to know that is that when you're playing as something as, fuck, Christ Isle is the Keeper, that's why you should always shoot the fucking fires and make sure you've done it. Knowing which one to shoot to focus on to get rid of some of the crap on the screen, so valuable. Like just having one thing to focus down rather than having to keep guessing which one it was that you last shot at. And of course the fact that it occasionally applies a status effect to said enemies, be it freezing or poison or whatever, also extremely useful. Didn't really need to pick up that coin, and it may have been a bad idea to have done so. But done it we did. Ooh, what a... Phew, I think we take Daddy Longlegs, mostly because our rate of fire is so poor, by my own hand, I acknowledge, that having a secondary damage source that we can just sort of rely on. So much... Oh, I didn't get a coin out in time. That's a shame. So much more useful, I think, than having more damage eventually. It's not just more damage in general. Money equals power would eventually give us more damage on our tiers, which are coming out so slowly. And having two coins right now, it's just going to do us no good. And it does you no good. But having, you know, plenty of... Look at all that. It just got rid of all that at once. No amount of money at this stage would be able to do that much damage with our tiers to that many enemies. And I think that's going to continue. That's going to work throughout the game. We've done everything here, although it took us absolutely fucking forever to do so. Shit, we do have a coin. We also have an orbital that we can use to do a lot of damage all at once to Gertie here. But we have to make sure that we're not in a silly position when he fires. But all our six shots are hitting at once, which I assume is better than hitting it six times. Ooh, tiers upgrade. How fast are we firing now? Wow, look at that. It's outrageous. We're crazy. We're demons. What's the matter with us? How can we be doing this much damage this fast? Look. We're going to need a much better... I bet number one would be great here. I think I will do that if we can find a way out. It is only a mob trap room. Thank you. So, it's not quite as scary as it could be as a prospect. Wow, I nearly walked on the spikes there. My moustache is tickling me, okay? Leave me alone. That was very scary, but we made it work. This is probably a good opportunity to use bombs. Or just Daddy Longlegs, I guess. Here you go. Excellent. That's actually, that's definitely something we need, so that was really worth doing. Obviously, we can't go into the curse room because it will kill us, and there is no way around it. But the Steven damage upgrade is so good. And to have this many shots doing it, we've got ourselves into a very much an Eve's Mascara situation where we've got a great amount of damage, but we fire so infrequently that it's almost not worth having. Except, I've got used to it. I've had it all this time. We've been playing this well with, you know, shit damage and a shit rate of fire. Got used to the shit rate of fire, and now the damage is amazing. I should really be flipping this coin. What's the matter with me? Step, flip. Thank you for being very easy to deal with. Daddy Longness just stepped in on the middle of all that. Oh, shit me. Help! Oh, you dick! That was such a bad room. Suddenly everything just turned over in my head. It's like, how do I fight gurglings? I've completely forgotten. One hit me. I needed the coin, and I forgot how to dodge the other one. My brain just switched off. I think I'm going to leave that there. That was a valiant effort, no doubt, but we didn't get what we came for. And I think we'll try in a different episode with a different character. But until then, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.